All of you, welcome to Max class. All of you, finish your previous homeworks. Somebody didn't get our previous class. That's why I just revised that part. Which one is previous class? Last class we have seen circle division. In this chapter, we will do circle division. One circle is divide into some equal parts. Okay, remembering? How many parts? First one, four equal parts. How many equal parts you got? First one, divide into four equal parts. Next one, eight equal parts. What happened that time? Angles are increasing time. Measures are decreasing. Okay, I give some homework also. Which one is a homework? One flag, one to draw with a Ashoka Chakra, 24 equal parts. I think all are finished. You are all very, very good students. That's why finished. Eh? 8 equal parts and 12 equal parts. That type circle one to divide. That time what happens? What happened that time? The number of parts is increasing time. Measures are decreasing. Measures are decreasing. That activity already finished. Next one, I told that day, each part is called angles. Each part is called angles. One circle is divided into each part. One circle is divided into each part. That part is called angles. That part is called angles. When form an angle? Anybody know? When form an angle? The two lines meeting at a point. When form an angle? Two lines meeting at a point. Then form an angle. When form an angle? Two lines meeting at a point. What one to? Two lines and one point. Two lines meeting at a point. That time form an angle. Once again, when form an angle? When forms an angle? Two lines meeting at a point. At a point. That time form an angle. Okay, clear? When form an angle? When two lines meeting at a point. Two lines meeting at a point. Then form an angle. Okay. What are the parts of an angle? What are the parts of an angle? Angles have two parts, which are arms and vertex. Arms and vertex. Which are the main parts? Arms and vertex. Which are the main parts of an angle? Arms and vertex. How many arms have? Two arms. Which one? Two arms have. How many vertex? How many vertex? Only one vertex. Let's see. A, B, C. Which one is arms? Which one is arms? A, B. A, B and B, C. Which one? A, B and B, C. Which one? A, B and B, C. Next one. Which is the vertex? Which one is vertex B? A, B and B, C. A, B and B, C. Which is the lines? That is arms. Which one is the center point? That is called arms. That is called vertex. Which one is the point? That is called vertex. For example, one more. P, Q, R. P, Q, R. In this case, P, Q, R. Arms are P, Q and Q, R. Which one? P, Q and Q, R. Which one is a vertex? Which one is a vertex? Which one is vertex? Which is the point that two lines are joining? That is vertex. Once again, which are the main parts of an angle? Which one? Arms and vertex. Which one? Arms and vertex. Angle PQR, which is the
PQ and QR. Which one? PQ and QR. Next one. Which one is the vertex? Which is the two lines are meeting in a point? That point is called the vertex. Okay. Next one. Which is the instrument used for drawing angle? Anybody know? Which is the instrument using for drawing an angle? Look at your instrument box. Which is the instrument? Do you have this model one instrument in our instrument box? What is the name of this instrument? Protractor. Which is the instrument? Protractor. What is the use of this? Drawing angles. How can draw angle using protractor? Already we finished the previous year using set square. How can circle divide and make some angles with the help of set square? Next, this year we want to study how can measure and draw with the protractor. This is the protractor. This is your instrument box. Have this tool. All of you take it this outside. Okay. Which are the parts of a protractor? Which are the main parts of a protractor? Just see one protractor. Okay. Protractor, all of you have protractor. Okay, which are the main parts of the protractor? Protractor, what are the? Look at how is your protractor? How many parts are there? What is the measures they have? 0 to 180. But two times have? Okay, one side of the 0 to 180. Again, reverse 180 to 0. Your protractor have that model? Okay. What is this? There have two scales. Which are scales? First scale is inside. That is called the inner scale. And that one line outside her again, 0 to 180, that is called the outer scale. That is the two parts of a protractor. Which one? Inner scale and outer scale. Which one? Inner scale and outer scale. Okay. First one, inside have one. For 0 to 180, that is called the inner scale. Next one, just outside have another 0 to 180, that is called the outer scale. That is the two main part of the protractor, inner scale and the outer scale. Inner scale and the outer scale. Did you see? Inner scale and the outer scale. Another special part of very important part is the center of the protractor. What is the center of the protractor? Your protractor have one black marker. That is center. Center, so many lines are joining that part. That is called the center of the protractor. Center of the protractor. Another line is the under have one line. But 0 to 180 one line have, that is called the baseline of the protractor. Which one? Baseline of the protractor. Okay, just look at your, what are the main parts of this protractor? Which are the main parts of the protractor? Baseline, center of the protractor. Baseline, center of the protractor. Inner scale and outer scale. Which one? Baseline, center of the protractor. Center of the protractor. Inner scale and outer scale. Which are the baseline, center of the protractor, inner scale and outer scale? Which are the main parts? Inner scale, outer scale, center of the protractor and baseline. Which are the main parts? Center of the protractor, baseline, inner scale and outer scale. Okay, next one. All of you clear it? What is the shape of the protractor? What is the shape of the protractor? Look like a semicircle or half circle. That's why, what is the measure of a circle? 360. What is the measure of a circle? How many angles have in a circle? 360. This is a half circle. That's why, how many degree have? 180 half of the circle. 180 degree. Okay. In this case, 0 to 180 there are marked. Okay. Two scales have inner scale and outer scale. Center of the circle and the baseline. These are the main four parts of the protractor. Okay. Just now, let's draw a circle. Just draw an angle. Okay. All of you take your scale and pencil and protractor. Take all of you scale and pencil and protractor. Scale and pencil and protractor. Okay. One new page taker. What is the bottom side? Otherwise, middle of the page. One to draw one angle. Okay. One was using outer scale, that also one to explain. Just one draw, one angle after explain. Okay, finish all of your first one. Draw an angle at 60 degree. Draw an angle at 60 degree. What is a degree? Did you know degree? Degree is the standard unit of measuring angle. What is a degree? Degree is the standard unit of measuring angle. What is the symbol of degree? What is the symbol of degree? That is small zero on the upper or top of the figure. Okay. It is the symbol of degree, that is small zero on the top of the figure. Okay. How can draw 60 degree angle? First one, draw a line. 5 centimeter. Draw a line. First step. Draw a line. 5 centimeter. Okay. Finish all of your. Okay. BC. That line's name is BC. Line is BC. Okay. B is the starting point of the line and C is the end point of the line. Okay. First one. 5 centimeter line draw, drawing after mark the point B and C. Okay, finish. B and C. B is the starting point of the line. C is the end point of the line. Understood? Next one. next one we want to do 60 degree angle. Now we want to draw 60 degree of a angle. That time center of the protractor, which one? Center of the protractor want to put on the starting point of the line. Which one? Center of the protractor. Which one is center of the protractor? The middle side one line. Hey, joining time. Can you see that is the center? That center is put on the starting point of the line. Where? Starting point of the line. But the baseline and our line is the same. Okay. On the baseline, put on the our drawing one line 5 cm. That on. That our baseline footage. Okay. Next one, we check it our inner scale. Check it our inner scale. Inside ratio is 1:8. Which ratio? Inside ratio. Inside? Inside ratio. Okay. Inside ratio. You did you see 60 degree and top have 120 degree and under have 60 degree. We want to use only inner scale. Only in the scale. That is 60 degree. Did you get 60 degree? Another have 1 point. Give 1 point and remove your protractor. Remove your protractor. Okay, remove. After removing, take your scale. After removing, take your scale and joining that point as a B point. Right? You got 1 point and the B point want to joining. That time you got 1 angle. That angle's measure is 60 degree. 60 degree. One more time I explain how can draw and measure an angle. How can measure? First one, draw a line 5 cm. Give to name. Which one? B and C. B is the starting point and C is the end point. B is the starting point and C is the end point. Just put it your protractor. Which part protractor want to put it? Which part? Center of the protractor. Which part? Center of the protractor. Center of the protractor. Put on the baseline. Okay, line. And measure the 60 degree. Which scale want to use? Which scale want to use? Inner scale. Which scale want to use? Inner scale. The protractor has 2 scales. One is outer scale and the next one is inner scale. When we use the starting point, we use inner scale. We use inner scale. Okay. And after getting point, remove the protractor. And just join the line. Just join the point and line. That time you got a 60 degree. That you got a 60 degree. Okay. That is angle is a 60 degree. What is a degree? Degree is the standard unit of measuring angle. 60 degree. Degree means a standard unit of measuring angle. Understood? What is the name of that angle? BC already have. What is the name of A? ABC. What is the name of angle? Angle ABC. What is the name of angle ABC? This is the symbol of an angle. Angle ABC. What is the name of angle ABC? What is the ratio? 60 degree. What is the ratio? 60 degree. Okay. Angle ABC. Okay. Clear all of you? All of you clear? Next, one more. Want to draw one more angle? Okay. Again. Draw an angle. Draw an angle 80 degree. Draw an angle 80 degree. Okay. Draw an angle 80 degree. What is the first step? 5 cm line draw. First 5 cm line draw. Okay. What is the area? R S. What is the area? R S. What is the measure? 80 degree. Now I change. I started that the angle is drawn on the end point. Where? End point. I put the protractor on the end point. Just to reverse. Next time, just before, we want to starting point. That is, protractor is put on the starting point. Now I just reverse end point. I put the protractor on the end point. Which scale now what to use it? Inner scale or upper scale? When we draw an angle with the starting point, we use inner scale. Just the reverse. When we start out end point, draw on end point. Want to use outer scale. Okay, outer scale. You got 80 degree. You got 80 degree point there. 80 degree and 100. 100 is inner scale and 80 is outer scale. After getting point, remove your protractor. After getting point, remove your protractor and join with the scale. How many degree you got? 80 degree. Which side? Just a reverse side. Okay. Just a reverse side. Now you got a RST. What's the angle scale? Angle RST. Angle RST. How many degree? 80 degree. Okay. 80 degree. Now you understand how to draw angle, measure the angle. Okay. Next one. Want to do so many angles, draw your notebook. I give homework for later for doing your notebook work. Next one more thing. Types of angle. What are the main types of angle? First one, 90 degree angle. What's the layer? 90 degree angle. What's the 90 degree angle? What is the shape of 90 degree angle? This type shape, real shape. Okay, this type of angle is called 90 degree angle. What is the name of 90 degree angle? Right angle. What is the name of right angle? What is the name of right angle? 90 degree angle name is the right angle. Next one is second angle. Below 90 degree. Below 90 degree. Angles measure below 90. What is the name of below 90? Acute angle. What's the name of acute angle? What's the name of acute angle? Acute angle. What's the shape of below 90? This is a closed figure. Next one is another one is above 90 or more 90. Above 90 degree. What's the measure? Above 90 degree. What is the name of that above 90 degree angle? Obtuse angle. What is the name of obtuse angle? What is the shape of that angle? Open figure. Okay? That type of angle is called a obtuse angle. This is the main important types of angle we will discuss in this chapter. Okay. Which are the main three types of angle? Right angle, below 90 and above 90. Below 90 angle is called acute angle. Above 90 angle is called obtuse angle. Okay, so many angles your textbook have that one to collect, that to divide it. Which group? Classify it. 90 degree. Which one is below 90? Which one is more 90? Okay, that is the one activity in your lesson have. And after one to draw and practice it, so many angles one to draw. Okay, one to conclude. Our time is over, that's why I will conclude our portion. Okay, which one is our today discussing topic? What is an angle? When form an angle? When form an angle? When two lines meeting at a point. When two lines meeting at a point. That is called an angle. That time form an angle. What is the main part of angle? Arms and a vertex. Arms and a vertex. Next one, which tool or which instrument is used for drawing angle? Which one? Protractor. What is the main parts of protractor? Baseline, center of the protractor, inner scale and outer scale. Next one, which is the main types of angle? 90 degree, below 90 degree and above 90 degree. Okay. All of you draw and understood that topic. I think all of you understood and interesting. This is a geometry chapter. That's why very interesting chapter, I think. Okay. All of you do more activities. I will give that through WhatsApp. Okay. Having any doubts, want to call me. Okay. Thank you.